Boeing has announced it has completed the upgrade and life extension of the first two service life modification F-18 Block 3 Super Hornets. They were completed a month ahead of schedule at the St. Louis facility and 2 months ahead of schedule at the San Antonio facility. The F-18 family of fighter jets has arguably been one of the Navy's most successful and versatile post-UAV-2 carrier-based fighter designs. The upgraded Block 3 Super Hornets now have the same capabilities as Boeing's latest new production Super Hornets. Boeing stated, in partnership with the Navy, Boeing has improved productivity and is completing Block II upgrades ahead of the 15-month contract requirement. The Block 3 upgrades include a large area display and more powerful computing, achieved through the tactical targeting network technology and a distributed targeting processor networked open mission systems processor. Mark Sears, Boeing Fighters Vice President, remarked, "These are just the first of many deliveries, with around 15 years of SLM deliveries to go. Our warfighters are counting on us to get this right every time." The upgrades are being carried out at Boeing sites in San Antonio, St. Louis, and the Navy's Fleet Readiness Center Southwest in San Diego. Captain Michael Burks, the program manager for the F-18 and EA-18G program office. "These first deliveries of Block 3 SLM jets are a major milestone in our continued efforts to ensure capability, reliability, availability, and maintainability of the Super Hornet aircraft. The Block 3 enhancements to the F-18 Super Hornets add a large area display and more powerful computing through tactical targeting network technology and a distributed targeting processor networked open mission systems processor." It was in March that the aerospace firm and the U.S. Navy's Fleet Readiness Center Southwest signed a public-private partnership agreement to expand the work scope and that allowed the Block II SLM work to be completed in both St. Louis and San Antonio. "These first deliveries of Block 3 SLM jets are a major milestone in our continued efforts to ensure capability, reliability, availability, and maintainability of the Super Hornet aircraft," explained Captain Michael Burks, program manager for the F-18 and EA-18G program office. "We look forward to our continued partnership with Boeing to deliver this critical warfighting capability to the fleet." Existing F-18 Super Hornets in the fleet are now on track to be upgraded to the Block 3 version, with progress to be completed by 2030. Delivery of the final 17 Block 3 aircraft is currently expected to begin in winter 2026 and reach completion in the spring of 2027, according to Naval Air System Command. That contract was valued at $1.3 billion and will include a technical data package that is described as vital to the sustainment of the platform. It was announced on Tuesday that the U.S. Navy has approved plans for L3Harris to equip the service's legacy F-18 Hornet and F-18 Super Hornets with advanced electronic warfare, ADVEW technologies. The contractor recently completed a preliminary design review, PDR, part of an $80 million contract to update key systems on the carrier-based fighter. Boeing continues to run its Super Hornet production line for the carrier-based multirole attack aircraft, but the production could cease after 2027 after the final aircraft are delivered to the U.S. Navy. While the aerospace contractor secured a new $1.3 billion U.S. Navy contract for 17 new Super Hornets. After months of tense negotiations on the price for the twin-engine aircraft, Boeing has failed in finding additional customers, while there remain no recent discussions with the Navy for any further F-18s. As previously reported, the aircraft maker will begin to slow down its build rate of 2 jets per month to just 1.5, while it pivots its St. Louis Super Hornet workforce towards other Boeing programs, including the F-15EX, T-7 a trainer, and MQ-25 refueling. The end of production of the F-18 won't actually mean an end to the program. The Super Hornet, an upgraded, enlarged, and improved version of the F-18 Hornet, first entered service in 1999. It has remained the workhorse for the U.S. Navy for a quarter century, and those final Super Hornets will likely be flying for decades to come as well. how cost-effective and otherwise viable any other potential changes to the jet's physical structures, including the placement of subsystems, another potential range-extending avenue NAVIR mentioned in its contracting notice today, might be as unclear. The Navy's existing Super Hornets have already been going through costly and time-consuming life extension and upgrade programs in recent years. New production jets are rolling off a line Boeing plans to shutter completely in 2027. At the same time, relatively small individual efficiency gains from more modest changes, such as vortex generators and drag-reducing techniques, coupled with improved computer-controlled flight systems and new tactics, techniques, and procedures, could all up when it comes to fuel economy and range. What is clear is that the Navy still has a significant interest in finding on-aircraft ways to extend the range of its F-18E and EA-18Gs. This comes amid an expanding air defense and anti-ship threat ecosystem that presents growing challenges to carrier-based aircraft and the ships in carrier strike groups. China's ever more capable arsenal of air-to-air, surface-to-air, and anti-ship missiles, as well as other anti-access and area denial capabilities, is of particular concern to the U.S. military. This reality can only contribute to lengthening distances between where carriers will have to launch their aircraft to reduce vulnerability and where those planes are expected to operate. We have already seen this translate to significant aviation-related developments within the Navy, particularly the development and now fielding on at least a limited level of the AIM-174B air launch derivative of the Multi-Purpose Standard Missile 6, ATM-6, which you can read more about here. F-18E are currently the only known launch platform for the notably large, heavy, and draggy AIM-174Bs, underscoring the value of new range-extending option, especially as alternatives to traditional drop tanks. Super Hornets are also set to be at least the initial launch platform for the Navy's Hypersonic Air-Launched Offensive Anti-Surface Warfare, HALO, Hypersonic Anti-Ship Cruise Missile, another weapon that is expected to be relatively large. Heavier stores loadouts translate to increased fuel burn, as well as less margin for carrier-based aircraft to bring them back to the ship.